Take a look at the highlights from the opening 20 minutes. A little back and forth early on. UND was hitting from deep. Anand Moody with three triples in the opening 10 minutes to keep UND close.
You know, he was taking good shots. Those are all good shots. They're all in rhythm, all within the course of the offense. He should continue to take every single one of those.
Moody was matching Kaysen Harrell shot for a while, but the senior from Pittsburgh eventually just took over. 16 big points for number 32.
Yeah, his experience really shined through in their consistency. You can tell Purdue Fort Wayne knows exactly who they are, exactly what type of offense they run, and they know exactly who to get the ball in the right spots on the floor.
Moody would keep UND close. John Conchar and company, though, just kept it rolling again, shooting, as you mentioned a moment ago, 56% from the floor, 46% from three from the second half. Again, it was a 16-point Mastodon advantage at the break. They extended it to 18, and it was, again, the usual suspects, the starters for PFW, really getting the job done.
Absolutely. Carl running the floor, stretching the floor on his three-point shots.
On the flip side, the bench for North Dakota, outstanding today. 58 bench points of the 73 scored for Brian Jones's team. Kaysen Harrell with 22 to lead all scorers. Anand Moody, a career night for him with 21, including six triples. He kept North Dakota in this contest, but just a little bit too much Fort Wayne in the end.
Yeah, I think, you know, the process that you go through in the non-conference schedule is going to continue into the first couple conference schedule games for UND. They're still trying to figure out who their rotation is, who plays well at which part of the game, and which combination of players play well together.
UND getting it within six towards the end, but clutch free throw shooting for the Dons and a couple timely stops end up being the difference. 84-73, your final. Again, another game where North Dakota doesn't win the rebound battle and does not come out on top of the scoreboard in the ends. They limit Purdue Fort Wayne to just one made three-pointer in the second half, but the Dons still shoot over 50%. They're 7-2 now on the season when they hit that mark.